Chris here with High Seas Cruising, and welcome to today's video. We are back this week with another video of what every cruiser wants. And I got three new cruise comments for you today. And today we're going to ask the questions. Are bars for adults or for family? Are you not a classy person if you're not using a knife and a fork? And then I actually have a legitimate one that I know has even happened to me, and I'm wondering if it's happened to anybody else as well. So let's jump right in with these cruise comments, and let's start here with the first one. We love a piano bar, and we actually skipped it our entire cruise this week on. For the few minutes we were there, was not impressed at all. There is far too much emphasis on adult material and songs with lurid themes. The piano bar is not the place for this kind of thing and should be family entertainment. Now, while I cannot speak for every cruise ship, every cruise line, because I have not sailed on them all, normally the way I see it is the earlier part of the piano bar is more family friendly, and the second half, as you get later on in the night, is a little more adult themed, you know, especially like on Carnival, they have it split up and it's, you know, a time where at this time, which I want to say is like 11 o'clock, it switches to adult piano bar versus the first half, which is more family friendly. But it is a bar. Bars are for the adults. I don't personally know if the piano bar should change the way it does things, because when they say more of a family entertainment, are you now thinking that it's going to be 9, 10, 11 o'clock at night and there's going to be small children in there? So the material has to be, you know, change to suit their ears? I'm not real sure exactly what they're asking for here, but I will say this. Look, it's a bar. It's a piano bar. It's for the adults to go in there, sing along, have a couple drinks, you know, act silly, act goofy, because that's normally what you see in a piano bar. People just singing, laughing, having a really good time. And yeah, it can get a little adulty themed. I've seen that before. Doesn't bother me, but it may bother some folks. So what do you guys think? Should the piano bar be a family entertainment venue, or should it stay just the way it is? All right, and on to our second comment. Now, this person here, they, to me, kind of has their nose stuck up a little bit in the air with the way they wrote this particular comment. And then I went and read the reader's comments afterwards, and it seems like the majority of what this person even said in this comment was absolutely wrong. Again, speaking for everyone and entire countries. And apparently, they spoke incorrectly. But let's read this comment and see what you guys think. Says, John, I have a question. Why do your pizza places on all the ships not have knives and forks available to eat the pizza with? I always have to go to another area of the buffet to get them. Have tables with a knife and fork. As you can see from my last name, I am an Italian American. Italian pizza should be eaten with a knife and a fork. Any Italian restaurant in the United States will provide cutlery as they would in Italy. Unless you are walking the streets and eating on the go, most people with class will want to use a knife and fork. All right, so let's break this down. So this particular comment, of course, relates to a Carnival Cruise Line ship. Every Carnival cruise ship I have ever sailed on, and it's been a few, what are we, 5, 6, something like that now, right there where you get the pizza, there are usually two baskets. One has just napkins in it, the other one has silverware in it. And if you do have to walk a couple of feet, let's say, right to the seafood shack, which is right there next to it, or right inside the doors to the buffet, silverware is readily available right there, but I've seen it on every ship right there at the pizza place. Now, I have never sailed to Italy, but all of the people in the comments that I saw, that I read, said in Italy, they do not give you a knife and a fork with your pizza. They use the fold method. You pick it up, you fold it, and you eat it. No knife and no fork, according to the comments. I said, I haven't been there personally, so you guys are going to have to let me know if that's right or if that is wrong. And what else I got from the comments is that really the only time that pizza is generally eaten with a knife and a fork is that if it is a Chicago deep dish style pizza, simply because they can be very messy. Now that's what I took from the comments. For me, I eat thin crust pizza. I use the fold method. I do not use a knife and a fork, but of course I don't speak for everybody. I only speak for me. You guys will have to let me know in the comments, do you use a knife and a fork when you eat your pizza? Because according to this comment, if you don't, apparently you have no class. And for our third comment today, now this one is not a complaint. This one to me is not a bad comment, but I think it's kind of a legitimate question and something that new cruisers may experience the first time they go out and cruise. Something that on our first cruise, we definitely experienced. Tiffany got it way worse than I did. But even I felt it there for a couple of days. And it's what I like to call land legs. And what I mean by that is, of course, you know, when you get on the cruise ship moves back and forth. Even if it's very slight and very subtle, it does move. And you kind of get balanced to the ship when you're walking around. Well, then when you get off at the end of your cruise, you still feel like the earth is doing this. And then, you know, I call that land legs. Not sure what everybody calls it, but that's just what kind of the name we picked up and have gone with. And that's where you feel like you're doing this the whole time. And this individual has had that problem, so let's take a look. I got off the Carnival Sunshine 2 days ago this morning. This was my first cruise, as well as the first for my two sisters. We were in a balcony cabin. The entire cruise experience way exceeded our expectations. Now, none of us felt seasick, but I was more sensitive to the ship's movement. I continued to feel it when we were off the ship on excursions, but expected it to stop soon after we were back on land permanently. It hasn't subsided. I've read that some people enjoy this feeling after returning home as it reminds them of being on the ship. I hate it, and I'm asking you for help, John. I called Carnival, and they said there was nothing they could do. How do I stop this? Please help me. This feeling is really unsettling, and I have not been able to return to work yet. So like I said, when I took Tiffany on her first cruise in 2016, she had this feeling for about a week. Now, I've seen several suggestions to counteract this. I've seen where if you take the seasickness medication once you get off the ship back on land, that can kind of help. Could be some kind of inner ear, you know, liquid imbalance that continues to, that helps this feeling continue for several days, even up to a week after you get off of the cruise ship. I would say that if it's been more than, you know, a week and you still have this feeling, you probably need to go have yourself checked by your doctor. But for first-time cruisers, even if you don't get sick on board the ship, you know, you don't get seasick, you could still feel this type of motion. I said, what we call land legs, even when you get off of the shore. And I said, I experienced it on my first cruise, but the fact that I've taken more and more cruises over the years, I really don't experience it at all anymore. Nowadays, when I get off the ship, it just feels like I just got off the ship and I no longer have the land legs. So it did go away over time. But you guys let me know in the comments below. Do you have a remedy for land legs that works for you? Do you even experience this, or did you experience it when you first started cruising? Maybe we can come up with some ideas and some solutions to possibly help this person out. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. All right, and that's going to be our video for today for what every cruiser wants. If you enjoyed today's video, do me a favor, give it a thumbs up. If you have not done so yet, do me a favor and hit that subscribe button. It is free to do so, helps our channel grow, and of course, we'll keep you up to date and let you know every time we put out a video. That way, you too can keep up with what every cruiser wants. All right, I hope everyone out there has a great day, and like always, we will see you out on the high seas.